Recently, I attended the largest classic car swap meet and car show in the Northwest. An automobile enthusiast brought his pot metal belt buckles that were broken in the same area on all three buckles. Pot metal is inherently weak and can break under daily stress. They broke where the steel buckle holds the belt. Now you can blame the pot metal or the third trip to the buffet. Super Alloy 1 rod and flux can easily save this pot metal belt buckle from forever living in the drawer. We use a Dremel tool to clean that repair area, and after cleaning, we added some flux by dipping the rod into the flux. Then we take our propane torch, broadly heat. When that flux starting to turn brown, then you lay your rod in. You can build up as much as you need with the Super Alloy 1. When in doubt, add more flux. Now after you're done, you let the part air cool. Then we're going to use some water and a wire brush to clean the flux off. Clean the pot metal or zinc die cast just prior to soldering to prevent oxidation. An oxidation layer can develop within an hour of grinding or sanding. So there's no need to clean the part the night before, clean it right before. Super Alloy 1 is not only the best rod on the market for pot metal, it also works on aluminum, steel, copper, pewter, brass, bronze, and more in any combination. For small parts like this, a Dremel, file, or sandpaper can be used to prepare for soldering. No need to get too aggressive, as pot metal and zinc die cast is extremely soft. Because this pot metal or zinc die cast has some mass to it, I'm heating it before I add my flux. Again, broadly heating is the key to pot metal repair. Now I dipped my rod into the flux, and you can see I just painted the flux on. And now I just simply cut off a little log of my rod, lay it in, melt it, I'm done. I don't want to add any more heat, I don't need to. Now the reason why I'm pulling this back and forth is because the Super Alloy 1 works so well that it'll even bond to the steel. Pot metal to steel, yes, that can happen with the Super Alloy 1. Again, let the part air cool. Then I'm going to come in with my water and a wire brush just to clean the flux off. And that's it. We never came close to softening the pot metal, let alone melting it. The Super Alloy 1 melts at half the temperature pot metal melts. You watch that flux. When it's brown, you're doing fine. If it turns black, stop heating it because you have about 300 degrees to go before the pot metal starts to melt. Another tip to keeping the part cool is add flux every time you add the rod. The flux is liquid and will help keep the part cool. I saved the last buckle for Bob. He's the owner of the buckles. I wanted him to see just how simple this was to repair.
I can't tell you how much I appreciate finding somebody to fix my belt buckle. I've had him around, I've asked all kinds of people, and everybody says they can, but they don't. It doesn't work. And one of them, well, none of those are available anymore. You can't buy them. And I've got a belt buckle collection. I've got over 50 belt buckles.
You do?
And these happen to be some of my most favorite ones. I've got over 50 different belt buckles, unusual belt buckles and everything, but I like the car ones the best.
Mm-hmm.
But these have been broken for more than a couple of years. I've got a machinist friend at home. Told me, hey, it's not possible. There's nobody that can do it. And he was a welder in the shipyard for years and years.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm tickled to death to get them done.
And you said the guy across the way that.
Down on the racetrack. I brought him down yesterday, and I didn't know you would be here or what or something. And he looked at it and he says, hey, you know, and he had all of his product laid out there, and he says, no way can those be done. They just can't be done. So you might as well throw them away and buy some new ones. I said, I can't buy new ones because they're not available. And so
we call them the pop can repair guys, because a lot of times they do pop can repair.
Yeah, he did have some of that.
Yeah.
He had, propellers and different stuff. But it wasn't that. He just said, hey, forget it. It's impossible. It's pot metal, and it can't, it cannot be repaired. Mm-hmm. He didn't say you can find somebody else or you can do anything. He just said it can't be repaired.
Right.
But sure enough, I'm really...
And what's your name?
Bob Mulliman.
It's frustrating to know that so many hard-to-find parts have been thrown away over the years when it's this easy to bring them back to life. And Bob, MuggyWeld would like to thank you for keeping an open mind to the so-called impossible repair.
The guy that had the belt buckles made, he ran out of them and doesn't move anymore, and I'll bet you the rest of them are all out there broken as well.
If you're one of those people with a broken belt buckle or any other zinc die cast or pot metal, here's your answer. Super Alloy 1 Rod and Flux.